it's Fran in the lab with a follow-up video, the first of, I think, several follow-up videos, from this module that was sent in by William Hanna, the Control Data C-Start Rack. And so I did a video on this where I opened it up and we found out that it's DTL and it was made in 1964. And after I put that video up, people commented that this was used as a initiator to start computer programs and routines, because any number could be dialed in on this panel, and then pushing this button executes the command. The sole purpose of this is to send a pre-dialed numerical instruction to a computer, and is used to initiate the start of programs, hence C-Start. And when videos collide, when I put up the video just, a few days ago, as I'm shooting this, the video about bad space movies, it was SuperViewer Matt Wetlisbach, who contributed all these amazing displays, who pointed out that in that shot of Future World, when I showed the clip and I was talking about Future World, I was showing the part of the film where they are showing these displays with these computer animations, which, by the way, were the first computer-generated animations to be in a motion picture, and those were done, I think, by Evans and Sutherland made those computer animations. But the set that they're shooting in, that's actually a room at the Johnson Space Center, as most of those other background sets are all from the Johnson Space Center. But in that room with all those paper recorders in the background and everything, in the shot of the panel when the guy's putting his hand on the panel, it's right there. That is one of these Control Data C-Start racks right there, showing the decimals on and everything. Well, it definitely inspired me. I mean, I will get to a point where we fire up this C-Start. One of the displays when I opened this up, these little indicators here, people said they thought they were switches, but they're not. These are just indicators. And people did point out that the bulb can come out of that lens, and yes, they're right, it can. Although I didn't try to pry it out, it didn't just fall out. But these are just indicators, but I did want to break one down, and so I managed to buy some more of these new old stock. These are from 1968-69. I got an assortment of them. From the catalog, they say that these are for using low voltages to control high voltage displays like neon bulbs and such, although the ones in the other rack mount are actually incandescent. But these contain transistor controllers in them. The idea being that you can use like a logic level voltage and logic level current demand, like in the 5-6 volt range, to turn on and off a high voltage display like a neon indicator, all in one package without the need to have like special support hardware or anything like that. So I'm going to bash one of these open because I can. We're going to take a look inside. Let's go to the bench. All right, so I've got an assortment of these guys. they range in date from 68-69. A lot of them have the tops broken off, but interesting, because they have some damage, we can clearly see here where the thread's been pulled away that this is an aluminum case, very fine, machined aluminum. It's probably spun formed, or it's basically a piece of formed aluminum. The threads on the front here have been torn off, but you can see some of the aluminum inside of there. And it's a very thin shell, and on the back there's this phenolic back piece where the contacts and pins come out, and that's been peened over, so it's basically just a crimp on that phenolic wafer to close it up. So I think the best way to open this up for me at the bench is just a brute force method. I'm just going to peen it. I'm going to peen it all around, basically to flatten out the crimp, and can probably just yank the back end right out. That's what I'm going to do. There we go. Haha. Oh. Oh, okay. There we go. Yeah, so this has got a switch. Yeah, okay, so I'm gonna take this outer insulator off. Little Mylar insulator. There's a little slot. Let's see here. Yeah, there's a slot right there in the plastic, and this phenolic board goes up in that slot. That just acts as a guide right there. There we go. And then that contact, there's the two contacts. It's kind of hard to get it together. Okay, there we go. And boink, there's a switch. That's the switch part right there. And behind that, we got a transistor in a can and a bunch of resistors. We're discombobulating this to destruction, so no worries. Oh, SS1504H, day code 1968. Single transistor, germanium, no doubt. Probably will be a high voltage transistor because this is a neon bulb. With one transistor, you really can't do, like, it's not like you could make an astable configuration where you could have a flip-flop. But it could very well be that pushing the button would be like a reset. If one of these pins could set the lamp on, and then pushing it from the front would be like a reset, turn it off. Well, let me decipher this and draw up a simple schematic. Basically it. My very quickly and crudely drawn schematic. Yeah, NPN transistor, got pin 1 is obviously control here, and also goes to the momentary contact switch. That's the switch that's behind the lens, and then we got another pin going out there, and then we got the high voltage there, and pin 4 obviously, and 3 would be the ground. And the transistor is just going to be switching on and off, either grounding out this or not. Basically, grounding out that pin to the lamp or not. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. Your guess is as good as mine about how the interaction between the front switch and the back switch, obviously there's two in play here, although it's pretty easy to see that, you know, pin 1 is activating the transistor. The base is going to be activated either through pin 1 or through the switch through pin 2 up there. So two options. And either or, pin 1 would activate remotely, and pin 2 would provide the same control voltage to be activated with the switch here. But it's pretty simple, just on off, you know, on off for the lamp. Pretty simple in a nutshell, but it was interesting to see exactly what they managed to squeeze into a tiny little package in the 60s. You know, and of course the marketing of these is pretty easy to see too. That, you know, you don't have to have any kind of support structure to be able to operate one of these. You know, just high voltage AC from a simple transformer and just a 6-volt control voltage to be able to turn it on and off, and you can get your neon indicator switchable with data, or manually pushed in the front. There you go. That's it. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks too to all of the patrons down there on Patreon. Would not be able to do any of this without you on the Patreon. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, so if you like this video or any video that I make, consider becoming a patron. It's really how we're able to do this. Just follow the link in the description. I will thank you personally. All right, that's it. I'm Fran. I'll be back here at the bench doing something else real soon.
At the bench again.